Hello students, welcome to my physics channel. In this video I am going to discuss about friction, guys. So what is friction? So in your lower classes we have discussed about friction. What is that, you know? A force which opposes the relative motion is called as friction. Exactly. For a change I will tell you the exact definition of friction, guys. Here, make a note of this definition. Write on. First thing is definition. What is friction? A friction is a contact force. Write down, guys. A contact force which supports at the relative motion. The relative motion, guys. Guys, you should understand three things here. Friction is a contact force. Sometimes it will oppose the relative motion and sometime it will support the relative motion. So it is not an exact statement that it always opposes the relative motion. It is not right. Sometimes it will support the relative motion, sometimes it will oppose the relative motion. Both are same. So you should understand that, okay? Suppose, for example, so you guys aware of opposing the relative motion, but where it will support the relative motion? For example, I am walking on the floor. Just because of friction only, I can able to walk front. So in that case, it will support the relative motion. This thing you should understand, guys. Okay, fine. I think, I hope you aware of definition of friction here. Next point I would like to tell is, friction is a contact force. I told you, already contact force it is. It is a contact force. So single body cannot produce any friction. Single body cannot exert any friction here. Let me consider, I am considering only single body. It doesn't consider, we can't consider any frictional force on this body. So one more body we have to take, either it may be surface or another block you can take. There will be existence of frictional force between one body to another body. That is why, because since it is a contact force. What do you mean by contact force? The force which will be exerted between contact between two bodies, then only the contact force will be existed. That is why, the reason I am telling, single body cannot produce any frictional force here, guys. I think, I hope you understand this. Next, I'll go for the second statement of this, that is friction. Write down, guys, this is very important. Friction is always depends on normal force, guys. Normal force. See, one more force we have introduced here, that is normal force, guys. See, in fact, the normal force is also one of the contact force in nature. Contact force, this is also contact force. Whenever two bodies, see, whatever the contact forces are there, so they will be existed between two bodies only. Minimum two bodies are required for them. A single body cannot produce any frictional force. A single body cannot produce any contact, normal force here, guys. See, according to the definition, the frictional force is directly proportional to normal force. See, if the normal force increases, the frictional force will increase. See, whatever the thing it may be, friction is always dependent of normal force. Without normal force, there is no friction, guys. So if you want to find the friction, so make it as a mathematical equation. So I can use some proportionality constant mu here, and I can write normal force here. This mu is called as coefficient of friction. What is that? Coefficient of friction, guys. This is the thing we need to know. See, suppose if you want to find the mu, means that is frictional force by normal force, guys. So you can take this. The ratio between the frictional force and normal force is called as coefficient of friction, guys. See, coefficient of friction is depends upon the nature of the surface. Let me consider. There is a table I am using here. There is a book on the table as placed. This is a big book I am going to place on the table. Now, every table surface, see, the table surface will have some coefficient of friction, some mu value. Okay, it's based on the nature of the table, it's based on the nature of the book, and that surface, it's based completely based on the surface, nature of the surface of that two books, guys. This is one book and another black. One black and another black. So there will be a surface called as nature of the surface. The surface may be rough, the surface may be smooth, the surface may be hard, whatever it may be. Based on that only it will be depends, guys. So mu is independent of any physical quantity. Mu is independent of any physical quantity. It depends upon the nature of the surface of the material. That's what I mean to say here. And one more thing, there is no unit. See, this is a ratio. Since it is a ratio between one force to another force, there is no units and dimensions for this mu, guys. That's what I mean to say here. I think I hope you understand the definition of a friction here. I think next we'll go for types of friction, guys. Be clear here, guys. Types of friction. Shall we go for types of friction? Yes. Let me write down. Types of friction, guys. Okay. Simply, I can classify the types of friction here. Very simple. What are they? Write down. Types of friction. There are two types of friction we can classify. One is static friction. Another one is kinetic friction. Kinetic friction, guys, that's all. See, easily I will tell you, listen. Static friction means, let me consider two bodies should be there. I told you, know, one is surface, another one is a black. Okay. If there is no relative motion, relative motion, that is called as static friction. If there is any relative motion, that is called as kinetic friction, guys. That's it. So simply you can understand, guys. See, there should be a relative motion between one black to another black, black and surface. Suppose two blacks, if I am taking two blacks, let me consider mass M1, another one is mass M2. There should be a relative motion. If there is any relative motion between them, then the friction is said to be a kinetic friction. If there is no any relative motion between them, then the friction is said to be a static friction. So easily we can say that, if any surface is taken, if any object has taken here, for example, this surface, let me consider like this. If this black is moving, then it is comes under kinetic friction, guys. Kinetic. If the black is at rest, then it is comes under static friction. With respect to what? The black is moving with respect to this surface, guys. That is very important. The black is at rest with respect to the surface, then only the relative motion is there or not we can able to find easily. I think I hope you know what is relative motion concept here, right? So this is how we have to define a static friction and kinetic friction, guys. So rest means static friction. So with respect to surface, the body is in rest means static friction. With respect to surface, the body is in motion means kinetic friction. Easily we can say that in a static friction, the acceleration of the black is zero. In a kinetic friction, the acceleration of the block is not equal to zero. Definitely, it has some acceleration, guys. Very, very simple. Once again, we can see these all things. Okay, fine. So next, how can you do the problems in this static friction and kinetic friction? We will see. See, guys, you have to write important note here. Write down the note here. First note, you have to write one thing. The kinetic friction, if you are finding, means that there is a formula for kinetic friction, that is mu k into normal force, guys. See, what is this mu k? Mu k is nothing but coefficient of kinetic friction. See, if the body is moving, we should consider this coefficient of kinetic friction. If the body is relatively at rest, we should consider coefficient of static friction. So any of the bodies, I mean any of the surface, suppose for example I am taking this is a surface, rough surface. Every surface has some static coefficient of friction, I mean to say coefficient of static friction, and then coefficient of kinetic friction. Both it has, definitely it will be having two types of coefficient of friction. One is mu s means what, guys? Coefficient of static friction. Another one is mu k value. What is mu k, guys? Coefficient of kinetic friction. And one more important thing here to note here is mu s is always greater than mu k, guys. This is very important conceptual understanding here. Mu s is always greater than mu k. Every surface having two kinds of friction, coefficient of friction. So what are they? Static friction, coefficient of kinetic friction. So rolling friction and all, we will discuss in the concept of rolling. You do not worry about it. Guys, I hope you are understanding. It is very clear for you all. Yes, kinetic friction is equals to mu k into normal force. Up to here, I think it is clear for you all.
See,
then one more formula you can frame for static friction. What is that? Mu s into normal force. It is exactly wrong statement, guys. It is exactly wrong. I will tell you what is static friction. Let me find first kinetic friction. I hope you understand the formula. Kinetic friction is given by the coefficient of kinetic friction into normal force. But static friction is not at all equal to mu s into normal force. There is no formula for static friction, guys, because static friction is a variable friction. Write down, guys, here. Variable friction, or else self-adjusting friction, we will say. Self-adjusting friction. Self-adjusting friction. Okay, I will let you know. Don't worry about it. Static friction. First of all, you just understand kinetic friction is nothing but Fk is equals to mu k into normal force. This formula is very important. And conceptually, we should understand that. And mu s is always greater than mu k for any surface. Okay, next I'll go for static friction alone. Let me consider how to define static friction, how to do the sums in the static friction. That's what we will see. And then we will go for kinetic friction, guys. Okay, fine. So let me consider first of all one surface I have, one black I placed here. This surface, luckily we have mu s value is 0.5, let me consider, mu k value 0.2. The thing is, mu s should be greater than mu k, any value you can consider. For example, I am taking. So let me consider, there is a 5 kg black I am going to keep here. Okay, see, these are the coefficient of frictions for what surface? Definitely for this surface, guys, for this rough surface. See, it is not frictionless surface, it is rough surface. For that surface, we have mu s value, mu k value individually. That point you have to understand at first here. Okay, fine. So let me consider 1 Newton force is applied here. Let me consider applied force here. Applied force. 1 Newton force I have applied here. Okay, let me consider. What is that? 1 Newton force I have applied. Is it possible to move, guys? 1 Newton force is... 1 Newton force is enough to move or not? That's what we need to find. So what is the minimum force required to push the object? That is the very important term in the case of static friction, guys. So what is the minimum force to be used to move this object? Is only one thing, that is called as limiting force. FL, we will say. Write down FL, limiting force. Limiting force, guys. Write down limiting force. What is limiting force? Write down the definition. The minimum force required to move an object on a particular surface is called as limiting force. The formula for limiting force is FL is equals to, write down, FL is equals to mu s into normal force. It is not static friction, guys. So far we have discussed that static friction, so kinetic friction Fk is equals to mu k into normal force. But I told you clearly, static friction is not equal to the product of mu s and normal force. In that case, then what is the product of mu s and normal force? That is FL, limiting force, limiting force. In some textbook, they will say limiting friction also. Both are same, no problem. No need to worry about it. So limiting force is nothing but mu s into normal force. Based on this only, we can able to find this black is moving or not. Are you getting my point? Suppose, for example, 5 kg black is placed on the surface, rough surface. The rough surface consists of mu s value, mu k value. I hope you understand. And then 5 kg black is supposed to move on this floor. And what we are going to consider here, let me consider 1 Newton force is applied on this. They will ask, what is the friction here? They will ask. Now, how to find that friction? Let me consider. See, let me consider this applied force is called as Fa, guys. Fa. Whatever the applied force they will give, variable applied force, 2 Newton, 3 Newton they may give. Let me consider that Fa, and let me consider limiting force as FL. Okay, conditions, write down the case. Case number one, not if Fa is less than FL, very very important point. If Fa is less than FL, then the friction is called as static friction, guys. Static friction. If Fa is greater than FL, then the friction is called as kinetic friction. Kinetic friction, guys. If Fa is equals to FL, then the friction called as limiting friction. Limiting friction. Limiting friction. This is equilibrium condition, or else equilibrium state, you can say. Both are same, means it may not be in the motion. Okay guys, so that is why this is the maximum value of static friction. That is why we will say limiting friction is the maximum value of static friction, we will say actually. So you can note this point also. See, Fa is less than Fl means static friction, I told you na. If Fa is equal to Fl means this is maximum static friction. Maximum static friction. That is nothing but limiting friction, we can say, equilibrium state, we can say, anything we can say here. So this condition is very important. Fa, the applied force is less than the limiting force. This condition is important. Once again, I am telling you, listen here guys. The applied force is less than the limiting force. Then the friction is said to be, what is that? Static friction. If the applied force is greater than the limiting force, then the friction is said to be kinetic friction. If it is kinetic friction, means direct formula we have, Fk is equals to mu k into normal force, directly we can find mu k into normal force. But if it is static friction, what happens? If Fa is less than exactly Fl, what happens? Okay, same condition here also. Okay, shall we do this problem? Yeah, before going to do that, you write down this. Then the frictional force, static friction, is given by the applied force, guys. Very, very important point it is. Do not forget this. What is that I told you? The static friction, whenever you want to find the static friction, very simple task. That static friction is equal to applied force, that's it. Whatever the applied force it may be. But the condition is, the applied force should be less than the limiting force. That is the condition. So without condition, you should not use this formula. Yes, exactly. I will do the example problem so that you can understand. So Fa is greater than Fl. Fa is greater than, what is Fa here? Applied force. What is Fl here? Write down guys here. Fa is applied force. Fl is limiting force. Okay. Then Fs is static friction. Fk is kinetic friction. Limiting friction means Fl. That is simple. What is that? Fl is equal to Fa is equal to, what is the formula? Mu s into normal force is the limiting friction. That is maximum static friction. See, suppose if they are asking the question, what do you call? What is the minimum force required to push the object up on a particular surface? That is called as maximum static friction. The minimums, that is what called as limiting force. Limiting force is nothing but maximum static friction. It is nothing but limiting friction also. So anything you can say here. And that the condition should be, the applied force is equal to Fl here. Applied force is less than Fl means static friction, greater than Fl means kinetic friction. Now I will let you know how to do the numerical problem regarding this, guys. Okay, shall I do that? Listen here carefully. The same problem I am going to take once again, guys. If you have any doubt, please let me know. Please let me know. You can give the comments in the comment section. See guys here. Let me consider there is a block of 5 kg. Same example I am going to take. There is a 2 Newton forces applied on this. There is a surface given. That surface mu s value is 0.5. Same values. Mu k value is 0.2 we are going to consider. Okay guys. See, if any question like this it has given. First of all we have to find a limiting force. Limiting force is the force we have to find. Why we are finding limiting force, I will let you know. Whether it is kinetic friction, whether the block is moving or not, we supposed to find first. For that, Fl you have to find. What is Fl formula, guys? Mu s into normal force is the formula for Fl. Okay, what is the normal force here? Normal force is acting downside. That is nothing but mg. So what is the Fl here? Mu s means what? Mu s 0.5, guys. 0.5 into, what is the normal force here? Mg, no, m means 5, g means 10. So finally we will be getting 25 Newton is the Fl value. The value of Fl, so minimum force required to push the object on the surface is called as 25 Newton. But here only 2 Newton is there. Definitely the block will not move. If the block is not moving here, then we supposed to go with the static friction concept. Yes or no, guys? Are you getting my point? Static friction means what is the formula? See, you know very well, Fa is less than Fl here in this case. In this case, Fa is less than Fl. Then the static friction is given by Fa. That's it. Say, what is the static friction? What is the value of static friction? Magnitude of static friction is nothing but applied force itself. 2 Newton is the answer. That's it, guys. This is how we are going to do. I hope you understand, guys. Yes or no? Let us suppose consider this is 30 Newton I am taking now. 30 Newton I am taking now. See, if it is taken 30 Newton, then what is the friction? Write down the question. What is the friction and what is the acceleration of the block? What is the acceleration of the block? These are the two questions we are going to do here now. First of all, let me find what is that. First, we will do as it is. Up to FL, it is fine. First step you have to do is FL. You have to find FL. Whether FL is sufficient to move or not. This applied force is sufficient to move or not. Exactly. It is more than 25, no? See here, 30 Newton is applied force. This is 25 Newton. What is the condition here? FA is greater than FL. Then what kind of friction we have? Kinetic friction. This is moving, no? Kinetic friction we have. Kinetic friction formula, direct formula we have. Directly we can find. What is that? Mu K into normal force is the formula for kinetic friction. Mu K value is 0.2 here. And normal force value 50 here. So, 10 Newton is the... What is that? 10 Newton is the... kinetic friction we will be getting here. Exactly. Now, how to find the acceleration? Second question is, how to find the acceleration? You have to go for FBD diagram of this 5 kg block. So, 5 kg block here we can take. This side, what is the Newton? 30 Newton is acting. 30 Newton is acting this side. And this side we will be getting 10 Newton. Then what is the resultant? Easily we can use the FBD equation. What is that? 30 minus 10 is equals to 5A. A is equals to 20 by 5, that is 4 meter by second square will be the answer you will be getting, guys. So this is FBD equation, guys. I mean 30 minus 10, it is a net force. Net force is equal to MA. M is mass of the object, guys. Mass of the object. So like this we are finding the acceleration, guys. I hope you clearly understood how to find the limiting force. Based on that, how to conclude that it is comes under static friction or kinetic friction. I hope it is clearly understood for you. Yes or no? So if you have any doubt, you can comment in the comment section is available for you. Definitely I will helpful in that way. Okay guys, any doubts up to here? So what we have discussed here, once again I'll recap everything. First, definition of friction. So sometimes the friction will oppose the motion, relative motion. Sometimes it will support the relative motion. Next one is friction is always dependent of normal force. So how it will be dependent? How many coefficient of frictions we have? Every surface having how many coefficient of frictions, guys? Static coefficient of friction, kinetic coefficient, coefficient of kinetic friction, coefficient of static friction we have. So this is what the, so how to decide whether the block is in static friction or the block is under kinetic friction? Very simple. First of all, you have to find the, what is that? Limiting force here. Based on limiting force only, we have to divide that. See, the limiting force is less than the applied force. The limiting force is less than the applied. Suppose, for example, the applied force is greater than limiting force. This kinetic friction, we can say. If the applied force is less than the limiting force, then what is the force we supposed to say? Static friction, we supposed to say. Then the applied force is equal to the limiting force. Then what we have to say, guys, here? Limiting friction. So limiting friction means what? It is at equilibrium condition. So the body neither moving nor in the rest. These are the things we have to understand here. Any doubts, guys, up to here? Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you, guys. Have a nice day.